data when it comes to understory birds, not just in the Amazon, but also many tropical forests. And macaws and wading birds have been generally extensively studied in the Amazon, and there's kind of this yearly project going on there, and extending the data for that. And this setting has never been done in these regions of the Amazon. Birds are an ideal group for assessing environmental stochasticity, because basically they rely so heavily on the forest. So if there's any change in that environment, then they're really interesting to study. Why this setting? As you can see, it's really dense undergrowth, so you just basically don't see these birds unless you are doing this setting. And it's kind of, you wouldn't be able to get this data unless you did this. My general aims and objectives is to test the relationships between body weight and allometric values, so tail lengths, beak lengths, all those different things. And then also I'll be looking into clutch size and incubation time, fledging time, and how that varies across diet and nest type. My methods were, they basically took us a day to set up the nets, and then we spent 5 days at each location, 10 hours a day nest netting. Our daily routine involved mainly a group of 5 of us. We opened the nets at about 5 in the morning to 5:30 as soon as it got light. And then at lunchtime we had to close the nets, otherwise it's too long for the birds to, they might get stuck in the nets and then that cause harm to them. And then at night time they were also closed. The nets were checked every 40 minutes. The birds caught were untangled and then taken to base camp, where we then take measurements of birds and then identify them and then bring them. So then if we recall those birds, then we'd be able to know which ones they were and not have to take them back to base camp and do the whole process over again. Morphometric measurements, this is what I was really interested in, the key to my project. Measuring the beak and the tail and the wing tarsus accurately for every single individual. And species identification was done on field with the birds of Prunebook and our master's student Karen, who basically knew quite a lot about Peruvian birds, and without her we wouldn't really have been able to get this far. So I had to compile my data once I got back to England. I used my data along with Peter Bennett's, and then also added to that by using the ZSL library and their resources, including the birds' handbook of the world. My results: there were over 366 individuals caught throughout 20 days, and that was 49 species and 20 families with different sample sizes. Here's just kind of a picture to show you the diversity that we caught in such a short time, ranging from kingfishers to hawks, puffbirds, owls. So it was a really interesting project to do in that sense. My results, I basically had to take the logarithmic values for all my dependent variables, which was the weight, and then also all the different morphometric values. And as you can see, there's a positive relationship with 99.9% significance, which is what I expected, because you expect the body weight to increase and then also the size of the beak and the size of the tail, etc. Again, another positive correlation. The only one which showed that there wasn't a positive correlation was the clutch size, which is what we expected, because often doesn't correspond with body size. Some hypotheses suggest it's to do with diet in the species. Here's a species which is probably my favourite. We only caught it once, but it's quite interesting. It's a burrowing species, so it has a long incubation and fledging time, which is often expected of burrowing birds. Also it eats a variety of food, from reptiles to mammals to small birds. And then this is kind of the opposite in the sense that there's not much data on this bird for the Royal Flycatcher. And it has a really lovely crest, and Ed's got a really nice video to show you of that. But it has a cut nest, which means it's more likely to get predated on, so it has increased broods per year. Also, the pygmy kingfisher, which we caught probably 30 individuals, it was caught quite frequently. person-to-person variations.